All right, I'm just letting everyone in. All right, we're going to give it like 3 more minutes. Okay, 2 more minutes and we're going to go ahead and get started. You guys are getting an invite to a new group in the app. Okay, everybody should have it now. All right, I'm going to go ahead and get started. I am still sick, but we are going to have the meeting. I'm not going to cancel it. And I'm not sure how much I'm actually going to talk, but I have my water and we'll see what happens. So Just a recap of week one, you guys all did amazing. Asking me to check over your food logs was great. Really wasn't anything I had to say, you know, you have 100 carbs left, or, you know, you didn't eat your carbs or anything like that. So everybody is doing phenomenal. Please continue asking me to check your logs. That will help you hit your numbers. You know, if you know you hit your numbers, I don't necessarily have to check your log, because obviously you hit your numbers. But if you feel like you need help because you're not hitting something, you know, definitely reach out. Or if you just want me to look at them and let you know that you did a great job, I have no problem with that either, which I love doing too, because you guys are kicking butt. I got a lot of notifications that people did not weigh in on Monday. Monday was a weigh-in. So if you did not weigh in on Monday, please make sure you weigh in tomorrow morning. This coming Monday is weigh-in and photos. Please make sure you guys do both. That is the way that you will see the difference when your body starts to change if the scale is not moving. Super important. A bunch of questions about the workouts. People saying that they really want me to know what they're doing. So I just need to know the amount of time you're working out. And you need to make sure that you told me whether it's lifting versus cardio, so forth. But I don't need to know what you do every day in detail, because I don't use that for your macros. I love that you guys log it and track it and everybody sees it and I see it. But if you're doing an Orange Theory and you're just going to hit general, it's okay, as long as I see you did that for an hour. It's not that there's no Orange Theory, so you shouldn't track it. Definitely track it. But I don't need to know. And same or what you're doing. And same thing with like lifting. Unless you want to keep track of every exercise, every set, every rep, all you have to do is go to general and put in a comment that you strength trained for 45 minutes. Like, you don't have to do that. But you have the option of saving your workout every time you do it under the workout tab instead of hitting activity. So totally up to you. If you are using the Lose It app, you can connect through Fitbit, which I've helped a couple of people do. That's a go around if you liked MyFitnessPal. Lose It, it's kind of like MyFitnessPal. Let me see what else I have in my notes here. I added a new group, which I added everybody to, and it's the Costco Trader Joe group. Only thing that goes in there is a Costco Trader Joe food. Please don't put Publix in there. Please don't put Walmart in there. Please don't put anything in there except something you find at Costco or Trader Joe's. And then all you have to put on there is Costco, Trader Joe's. This way we can keep it short, sweet, no nothing on there. This was great. I found it. It was yummy. It was delicious. Don't put any of that. I started it off by putting two items on there. And I'm just like you guys. I search the web. I find things all over. Like, there's nothing new. Not one dietitian, not one nutrition coach, not one macros coach is coming up with anything new. So I search the web just like you do, and I share what I find. And you guys can do the same. Like, if you have somebody that you follow and she says she goes here all the time, whatever, share it. Recipes, same rules apply. Because what I find is what I share with you guys. And you guys don't know I don't cook. So I'm definitely taking it from other people. So you guys are all in that group now. There's a little daisy and it shows the two things I added. So all you're going to do is add a picture of the food, where you got it, and that's it. Because if they need the macros, it's not going to be the same macros anyway. Because if someone does a quarter of a serving or a half a serving or a full serving, the macros are going to be different anyway. So you can Google the item or go to Costco or Trader Joe's. And when you buy it, figure out how much of it you could have that fits your macros. All right, next thing is alcohol. I added a group again, alcohol, because I took it away because I felt like nobody needed it. But I added it back because over the weekend I was out and I probably got 9 messages while I was out about how to calculate their alcohol. So I think while I was out, I actually did it. I went in the bathroom and did it. But when you are calculating alcohol, it's either carbs or fats. If you're using carbs, it's 4 calories. If you're using fats, it's 9 calories. You divide it by the amount of calories that are in there. That's how many carbs, that's how many fats you'll be using. If you want to use both, just split it up however you want to split it up. And then when you go into My Fitness Pal, if you're adding it in My Fitness Pal, you're going to create a food. You'll label it. You'll put the calories and whether you're using carbs or fats. There are no proteins and alcohol at all whatsoever. Don't let anybody steer you differently. All right. So the meeting today is going to be about goals, SMART goals, and vision boards. Raise your hand besides the people that have been in the Shred Tribe that have already done their vision boards for me. Raise your hand if you've never done a vision board. Well, Danae should not be raising her hand because she's been in the Shred Tribe and we've been doing vision boards. Okay, so vision boards are super important because your goals that we're going to talk about, you can put on a vision board. Now, you don't have to make a vision board like this per se. There's apps and we're going to start sharing a few of them, but I just want to show you before we go on with anything so you don't get overwhelmed about vision boards. Okay, there is an app called Pick Collage. It's free. And you have choices of a grid, freestyle, however you want to use it. And I'm going to show you my collages. So this is one of my vision boards from years ago. And you just put the pictures on that you find on the internet and you do freestyle. So I'm guessing this was when I just started my Facebook group, which is so funny to me because that was a very long time ago. That was like 9 or 10 years ago. That's how long I've been using this app. Okay, so that's where you can make your collages for your vision boards. Your vision boards can be sayings, they could be if one of your goals is to take a family vacation, it could be a picture of your family vacation. If your goal is to get a new car, it could be a picture of your car. If your goal is to get in that little black dress for your birthday, you could put a picture of a little black dress on there. Doesn't have to always do with the Shred Tribe, but put one thing on there about the Shred Tribe, just so I know that that's part of your focus, part of your goals. Okay. So people often struggle at achieving their health goals when they set goals too big. And I talk about this all the time with how much weight you want to lose. And people are like 50 pounds. And then I put 10 in the app and then I get a message that it's 50 pounds. And I'm like, no, 10 is easier to achieve, right? Same rules apply with all your goals. So if you set two goals that are too big, too broad, like how am I going to get there? You have no clue. Or too that don't have a plan. Like you just, I'm going to lose 50 pounds. How are you going to do it? I don't know. Right? That's how you're going to achieve that goal. You have no way of knowing how you're going to get to that end result, right? So basically you're sabotaging yourself. You're undermining your efforts of that goal you set for yourself. As I start talking, I want you guys to start thinking about a goal for being in the Shred Tribe. It may not be weight loss. It may not be body fat loss. It may be getting in an outfit, which is inches. It may be getting extra energy. It could be getting your blood work better. There's so many reasons why people are in the Shred Tribe. It's not just, I want to lose weight. So I want you guys to start thinking of that. When we have such hefty, lofty goals, we have the tendency of failure because when we don't get there fast enough, or we have no way of knowing how we're going to get there, you feel like you're failing and then you don't try to reach that goal. A lot of people in the Shred Tribe and in life struggle with food, right? And that's why we yo-yo diet so much. And if you set a goal for yourself of I'm going to change this habit of how I eat this type of food, by doing this, whatever it is, however you're going to do it, then you'll reach that goal and you won't be yo-yo dieting all the time. Allowing yourself the freedom to have the 10 M&Ms every day because you tracked it, or that Dove piece of chocolate, or that glass of wine because you tracked it. So you being in the Shred Tribe, you have that goal. Your means of quantifying what you're doing is by tracking every day. You're able to reach your goals because you see what you're eating and you're eating for your goals. Don't use that, by the way, when I give you your homework. Seeing no improvement in our health is why we yo-yo. I'm on a diet. I lose 5 pounds. I feel awesome. Don't see it the next week. I'm going to go back to eating. And then I'm like, okay, well, I'm going to try it again. And now our weight goes up and down, right? We don't know why, because we don't know why we're doing this to ourselves, but it's because at the end result, we don't have a goal in mind on paper that we can look at how we're going to get there. When we set unrealistic goals, it will unmotivate us. So your goals have to have a certain couple of things, which I'm going to go over with you guys, but realistic goals are super important. If I put in the app that you weigh 300 pounds and your goal is 200, and I put your goal is 200, how is that going to feel? Is that going to be unmotivating every time you lose 1 pound? Right? You're chipping away at that number. But if you weigh 300 pounds and I put your goal 290, and now you're seeing 294, 293, 292, 291. Damn, I'm in out of the 200, you know, 300s. Like, that's way more motivating. So our goals need to be more realistic for short-term goals. Value of new habits will help you get there. So as you're writing these goals, think about what habits you're doing or what you've changed to get there. Like, my sister is not on here, I don't think, because she has COVID and she's not feeling well at all. But my sister, one of the habits she changed was working out. I've never known my sister work out, ever. And she put down one of her goals that she was going to work out at least 3 days a week. Now she's doing it every day. She's addicted. And she's down 80 pounds since she started with the Shred Tribe. She had a goal. She had habits that she changed. She worked towards it every single day, and she is reaching her goals. If you have trouble after you make your goal and adhering to the goal, I want you to think about why you made this goal. It's more underlying than I want to lose weight. Why do you want to lose weight? It'll make me feel better. I'll be able to run around with the kids. I don't have to use 2 seatbelts on the airplane. I don't have to be embarrassed when I go out for dinner and the chair breaks. I mean, I don't know. But there's always a reason underlying. I use the wedding as an example. Like, I want to lose weight to get, because I have a wedding to go to. Do you really want to lose weight for the wedding you want to go to? Who will be at the wedding? Like, my sister, her stepdaughter is getting married, her bonus daughter, and she wants to look really good for the wedding. Well, does she want to look really good for the wedding for herself or because the ex-wife will be there? And we've gone down to them. We've talked about it. But there's always a reason that goes deeper and deeper and deeper. And writing out your goals and that deeper reason will help you stay more motivated into your goals. Raise your hand if you're doing the transformation challenge with Orange Theory, if you're signed up for it. I think there's actually only a couple of people in here from Orange Theory, but good. I am too, Catherine. I'm doing my InBody in the morning. Andrea, are you doing it? I didn't know if you weren't. Oh, okay. It is a great way to stay focused because it helps you stay motivated. And the end result goal, you guys can have a goal for yourself because you're going to get another InBody at the end, which is awesome. Clear goals give us a finish line. We know our end result because we wrote down what our goal is. If you wrote down that you wanted to lose 10 pounds, you know you didn't hit your goal at 8 pounds. But at 10, you did, because you wrote down that was your goal. It's something to work towards, and it gives you a general direction. Same thing with your vision board. When you put stuff on your vision board, you get to clear it off that vision board, especially because we're using an app, every time you hit that whatever goal or whatever it is on that vision board that you foresee in your future. Goals will serve as a way to reinforce desirable behaviors and increase motivation. When we do our vision boards, I tell you guys to put it on your screensaver so you can see it all the time after we make them, because it's a source of motivation. It will help you not get derailed by looking at that motivational vision board. We've had people put pictures of them from the past on their vision board as a goal for the future. Some ways of thinking about your goals is a couple of questions to ask yourself. How do I want to feel in the next 6 months to a year if I achieve this goal, whatever the goal is? What steps do I need to take that to achieve that, and what actions do I need to take? When I've tried to do something like this in the past, how successful was I and why wasn't I successful? And what will I do now to change that? Where will I struggle? What tools will I use to help me reach this goal? We all know one answer. If it's weight loss, it's going to be short trip. And how do I see myself achieving that? And how will I feel when I achieve that? We live on feelings, emotions. When we're sad or angry, we tend to eat, right? When we're happy, some of us eat more when we're happy, it depends. But we, even though you don't realize it, a lot of us eat our emotions, wear our emotions. I know I do. I'm a Leo. I wear my heart on my sleeve. If I'm having, I don't try not to bring it into work, but if you know me personally, you can always read my face or how I'm feeling or what's going on, if I'm quiet or whatever. And it's the same thing with your goals, with your vision boards, and how you're going to achieve them. So SMART goals stand for specific, measurable, attainable, realistic, and there has to be a time connected to it. Every business I've ever been a part of, whether it's MLM or worked for a company or anything, we've always had a meeting about SMART goals. Always had like a breakaway at a conference about SMART goals. So I'm sure you guys have all heard it before, especially if you've been with me in the Stretch Tribe. But so specific means create a clear, specific goal describing the outcome and target and an area of improvement. So a non-specific goal would be, I want to lose weight. A specific goal, I will start walking for 30 minutes on the treadmill 3 days a week and to improve my health and energy levels. So you gave the goal, how you're going to do it. It's realistic, right? You said what I didn't left this part out, but Mondays, Tuesdays, Saturdays, being specific about what you want to do and how you're going to do it. Measurable. So obviously your weight, measure your goals, or body fat, or inches, or I'm going to read a book every day and I'm going to read 10 pages every single day. And I'm going to finish this book by this time. Or for me, I need to make a goal for this certification that I've been sitting on, that I pick it up and do 5 pages every 5 days for the female menopause and PTOC and all that stuff. Attainable, set an achievable goal that you can realistically accomplish in a time frame. Start small, but achievable goals that are easily outlined into specific steps will let you meet your smaller goals, which will eventually end up into larger goals. Hence the 10 pounds. If you lost 10 pounds three times, you lost 30 pounds. It's that easy. And it goes that quickly. Every 8 weeks, you can lose 8 to 10 pounds. People say, do you think by June I can lose 30 pounds? Hell yes. No doubt in my mind. It's 6 months from now. If you stick to it, make your goals, make a vision board, be engaged, hold yourself accountable. And for your goals, you have to track every day. Yes, you will lose 30 pounds by June. No doubt. And I would guarantee it, but I don't live with you. So I have no idea what you guys are doing on a daily basis, except what you tell me. Be realistic, make sure it's relevant, create a SMART goal that aligns with your values and long-term vision of health. Make sure your goal has start and end date. You want to create real time based on parameters for yourself. You're not going to lose 30 pounds next month. I get that also. Do you think I can lose 10 pounds by January 27? Well, it's the 12th or 18th, so absolutely positively not. You could lose 2 pounds, maybe 3 pounds, but otherwise, no, it's not going to happen. Visualize the big picture and start to break it down into steps using the SMART goals structure that I just said. That will help you. You only need to make one goal, by the way. One goal for me for homework. The vision board is anything you want to put on there. And then I usually pick 3 to 4 vision boards every week to go over. So people get to know you, who your tribe friends are, and then to talk about goals and stuff, because it's pretty cool. First step in creating a sustainable habit is to be specific about your goal. Making a broad statement and then specifically outlining it could be a good start. So a new habit would be, I'm going to sit down with my book. I'm not going to have my phone near me. I'm going to turn off my TV, and I'm going to read my 10 pages every single night. This is not a goal of mine because I will never achieve it. So I will never make it a goal. I know myself. I did, however, do you guys all know that I'm obsessed with Dateline podcasts? I've talked about it a lot. Obsessed. I'm back from 2023 to 2020. Every time I get in my car, since I found this, I listen to a podcast and it's been another Dateline, or it finishes the last one or whatever. I can't get out of my car until I finish it, or I take it in with me and finish it, whatever. Obsessed. Prior to finding Dateline podcasts, I was reading or podcasting self-help, macros, nutrition, fitness, every time I'd be like learning, and I got away from it. And I got in the car on Monday and I was like, oh, let me pull up my Dateline, find the next one. And I said, you know what? I'm making a new goal for myself. I get to listen to a Dateline podcast once a week on my furthest drive to and from wherever I'm going. Any other day, I can listen to any other podcast, but it cannot be Dateline. I'm on Wednesday and I'm doing good. 2 days. So far, so good. 3 days, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. But I am obsessed and addicted with it, and I can't stop thinking about it. But my goal is to achieve this, to do it for 30 days. And in 30 days, for one thing, I would have created a new habit because it takes 28 days. I don't believe in 21. It takes 28 days to create a new habit, and I'll be off of that cycle. Some things I can't do that with, like my Swedish fish. I just got to break that addiction. No goals. Okay. So the trick to setting smarter goals is that you start, and to achieve them is to start smaller, little goals. Small changes are easier to make and can lead to big results, as I just talked about. This is kind of what I was talking about with your weight loss. But you slowly, 10 pounds, 10 pounds, and then all of a sudden, this whole chunk is gone. And I'm sure you can visualize it just without that chart, but I thought it was a cool chart. Wow, I said I wasn't going to talk a lot, and I haven't stopped talking. Okay. So now you have to start thinking about how you're going to achieve these goals. So I want to lose weight. Be specific. What behavior? I will increase my daily activity by getting on a stationary bike. Or I will increase my protein intake and get closer in my 10 grams over under every day for the next 14 days. Or a great goal would be, I'm going to hit my macros 10, 10, and 6 for the next 2 weeks. And I'm going to do this by increasing my protein intake at breakfast, lunch, and dinner. Decrease my fat, depending on what situation you're in. And in 2 weeks, you'll be amazed by the results you'll get. By one, on the scale, and two, how good you feel that you reached that goal. Write down your goal, and you have to write down anyway, because I'm going to ask for you guys to send it to me for homework. And when you're doing it, determine how you're going to measure your success or track your progress. So with the book, by 5 days, you've gotten 50 pages read. You're starting to hit that goal. Tracking your macros, day one, 10, 10, 6, day two, 10, 10, 6, day three, 10, 10, 6, or 3 days in. Depending on what your goal is. And if you need me to help you with these, I'll help you with figuring out all the specifics. Make your SMART goal achievable, but be ready for obstacles. I was planning on reading, this is not true. I was planning on reading tonight, but we have to go out for dinner. How am I going to get those 10 pages in? When I tried 75 hard, you had to read every day. And I would save it for a certain time. And I literally didn't make it, by the way. I didn't do 75 hard. And it was mostly because of the reading. So you have to read like 10 pages every day. And it couldn't be self-help. It had to be like fun reading. And I would leave it for the end of the day every day, but I was so exhausted that I wouldn't do it. But if I had planned ahead of time and said, oh, I have 15 minutes in between this client, I'm going to read my book just in case I can't get there. Or at this time, I'm going to wake up 5 minutes earlier and get the right book read or whatever I did, I would have been able to achieve that goal. So prepare for obstacles. Maybe you're not going to be able to hit the 10, 10, 6 because of something happened during the day. You had planned to do this for dinner, but now you're going out. But you got to keep on track to that same goal you set for yourself. So we're always going to have potential pitfalls, but you want to plan for ways around them and create a goal, kind of like what I was talking about. But an example of a goal without attainable criteria is, I haven't worked out in over 2 years, but I'm going to start biking for 5 days a week. That would be definitely not an achievable goal. You didn't set any criteria. How are you going to get that done? Example of an achievable goal. I would like to start working out again. I'm going to start first by biking 2 to 3 days a week for 30 minutes on Monday, Tuesdays, and Saturdays. Same thing with the book example. I want to read a full book. Obviously, it's not going to happen, but I'm going to go chapter by chapter. I'm going to read 10 pages Monday, Wednesday, Friday until I'm done with the first chapter. And I'm going to keep going until I'm done with that book. So I'm short-term built into a long-term. Just like your 10-pound goals are short-term built into a long-term goal. If you get stuck on your goals, take a step back, reevaluate, think about your behaviors, think about your habits, read your goal and see where you can fix it and go back into that goal mindset. For your homework, I just want to make sure I didn't miss anything. We're all going to write one goal for Shred Tribe. Your vision board can be of anything. It could be sayings, pictures. It could be real pictures of family. It could be... it could be absolutely anything. It could be business oriented, professional, personal. It doesn't matter to me what you do, but everybody's going to create a vision board. It is not an option. You don't have to share it with everybody, but you have to share it with me. But it's not an option. Everybody needs to create a vision board. And I'm going to let everybody know that that's not in the meeting, that they need to watch the meeting because there's homework. But I'm not going to tell them what it is because I want to see if they watch the meeting. And you guys know I could see views of who watches meetings. I don't know if you guys know that or not, but I can. So when you're done with your vision board, just screenshot it, send it to me in the private messaging. Nobody else sees it except me. I will always say, can we share this in the meeting next week? And if you say no, no, no big deal. Next week for our meeting, it is share and tell. So everybody's going to bring an item or two of something that they have to have in their day, whether it be mush or almonds, or they found these amazing Kodiak waffles or whatever it is. And we do this every meeting because it's amazing the food that is out there that a lot of us don't even know. I've been doing macros for 15 years and people are like, oh, I found this, blah, blah. I'm like, holy crap, I'm going to go get that. I mean, I've had some failures. Magic spoon, I will never eat it. My sister loves it. It's cereal. It tastes like real cereal, but it doesn't. But if you guys have given me such amazing finds that I didn't even know existed. And then when you give them to me, I usually put them in my Amazon shop. So if you guys don't see them anywhere, you can get them there for there. Once we do the share and tell, then we add them into the amazing foods group. And that's where that originated. So I try to get through as there's no meeting. It's this. And I start and I say, who wants to share first? And I usually say, what is your name? Where do you live? And what is your item? And I need the macros and whatever the item is, a picture of the item or the food in hand. And I always say, where do you live? Because there's people in here that live in California, Canada, Trinidad, Dubai, France. So it's cool to hear where all these people are getting these different foods from too. Even people from New York can get some foods at Aldi's that we can get and vice versa, whatever. So that's the meeting next week. So you have actually three homeworks. Vision board, one goal, and bring something with you to the next meeting. Everybody got it? Okay, I'm so sorry I canceled the meeting, the workout last night. I sound horrible, but I felt horrible yesterday. And I just could not muster up the energy to do another workout yesterday. So I apologize to you guys for that. I try not to cancel anything, but I couldn't breathe. So hopefully you guys understand that. All right, so I'm gonna let you all go. Thank you so much for coming on tonight. Remember, always be badass. I have a bunch of protein cheat sheets that I'm gonna be adding into the protein group tonight as well. Sorry, I'm catching my breath. I was going to talk about protein tonight, but I was like, cheat sheets are so much easier. Instead of having you guys write everything down as I talk. Like, oh, this protein's good and this protein's good. Pictures are so good. And then I also thought I was going to make a new group of gluten-free food. Because a lot of people are, I know, Danae. A lot of people are asking me about gluten-free stuff. So I'm going to add that group too. If you don't want to be in it, you don't have to be in it. Just let me know. Any group that you're in right now that you don't want to be in, Danae cracks me up. Show your notes from this meeting. She takes notes at every meeting. She kills me. If you don't want to be in a meet group, let me know. I'll take you out of it. You don't have to be in all of them. There's only certain ones I'll say no about. Okay, I'm going to get off because we're going to get canceled and I'm going to get shut down. Remember, always be badass. Thank you so much for coming on tonight. You guys are amazing. Thank you for staying engaged. I will see you on the app and don't forget about all those homeworks. Bye, everyone.